Assalamu alaikum, how you guys doing? We're in this beautiful town of Zenica. It's about an hour away from Sarajevo. And we met another brother here in Zenica who's also a world champion. And he's going to talk about some of his accomplishments. And then we're going to ask those crucial questions. You know what they are. But let's meet the brother first. Assalamu alaikum, Bahruddin, Kakosi.
Wa alaikum assalam, alhamdulillah, I'm fine, thank you. How are you guys?
Yeah, right, good, alhamdulillah. So you're a world kickboxing champion, yes. Is that right? That actually retired, you're done with it.
Yeah, se zovem Bahruddin Mahmić, treniram već kickboks više od 10 godina. Nizao sam dosta rezultata, jedan od najznačajnijih tih rezultata jeste svjetsko prvenstvo koje se desilo 2017. godine, koje sam osvojio, hvala Bogu. Kada sam počeo trenirati, imao sam cilj da dođem do svjetskog prvenstva, to jest da ga osvojim i da na neki način postanem svjetski prvak. Te godine 2018. sam osvojio svjetsko prvenstvo, moj cilj je jel, gotov, tako da sam s takmičenjem i završio. Osvojio sam 34 puta državno prvenstvo, 3 puta sam bio balkanski prvak, 3 puta osvojio svjetski kup. 2011. godine sam bio srebreni na svjetskom prvenstvu i eto 2018. krunisao sam svoju karijeru zlatnom medaljom kojom sam i završio svoju karijeru.
You know what's very unique he shared with me, and this goes back to when it's written and it's going to happen, it's going to happen. He almost had his life taken from at a young age, about three, four years old. Can you share that with us? What happened to you?
1993. četvrte godine, baš ne znam koliko je točno bilo, granata je pala blizu mene nekih pola metra, tako da je detonacija mene odbasila u kontejner. Jedini sam koji je preživeo s tom granatom, to je kad stvari koja je pala ta granata.
Can you guys imagine that now? You're a young kid at 3-4 years old in a grenade. You don't, but by now you guys know that we're in Bosnia and this is where the greatest genocide happened after World War II. So they had grenades, bombs, all sorts of things going on, but he got to go ahead and make it through that. And now I'm asking you this very important question. What had you turn to Islam at such a young age that you've been committed now for the last almost decade?
Yes. Moja mama, alhamdulillah, je bila ta koja je na neki način uticala da ja počnem klanjati. Ona ne praktikuje svih pet, mislim tada nije praktikovala svih pet vakata, ali eto hvala Bogu sada već praktikuje, znači usmjeravala me u tome da treba klanjati. I 2016-17. godine sam hvala Bogu odlučio da počnem klanjati svih pet vakata. A ono što me je natjeralo jeste jedan insan, mislim nije natjeralo nego ono što mi je pomoglo, jeste jedan insan koji se zove Sabrija Osman Bašić. On me na neki način tu najviše pomogao kada sam išao u džamiju s njim tamo vamo, govorio me kako nema ljepše osjećaja nego biti musliman. Ono što me najviše pomoglo u tome da počnem da klanjam svih pet vakata jeste što sam na neki način osjetio i smiraj koji se desio u meni kada sam počeo da klanjam svih tih pet vakata i shvatio sam da je to ono zaista što meni fali, tako da sam počeo što bi sve više ići u džamiju, da se družim sa muslimanima, da se družim sa braćom koja se nalazi u džamiji. Tako da na neki način je to ono što mi je falilo zaista svih tih godina, sad to moje djetinjstvo i hvala Allahu, eto već neki više od 10 godina sam u vjeri, alhamdulillah, da ostane tako ako Bog.
Do you feel this peace, this happiness in Islam now that you're practicing it and living it?
Moj osjećaj sada kao musliman, volio bi da svi osjećaju ono što ja osjećam, ali nažalost ne možemo svi osjećati onaj koga Allah uputi na pravi put, da sad ne pričam o tome. Ono što ja osjećam, samo ja znam i moj gospodar, i molio bi i molim Allaha da svi mi koji smo za upute, da budemo za upute, da nas Allah uputi na pravi put, učini iskrenim muslimanima i da budemo iskreni vjernici i da nas Allah počasti u društvu poslanika sallallahu alejhi ve sellem.
What advice do you have for other people in the Balkans, like Serbians, Croatians, people who are seeking to know the purpose of life They want to know why they've been created. We know the Quran is from Allah, from the Creator, is the blueprint for life. But now there's this nationalism, right? Are you ready tomorrow if someone's Serbian and comes here, wants to become a Muslim, to accept him like your brother?
Bez obzira na naciju, svi smo mi neki ljudi. Ljudi se gledaju po tome koliko je ko spreman da pomogne jedan drugom, koliko će se pomoći jedno drugom. Tako da bez obzira na vjeru, ja imam potrebu da ako je neko u problemu da ga pomognem, da mu olakšam, da to svedemo na neki normalan nivo. Tako isto očekujem da od ljudi koji su druge vjere, znači nije da mi sada nešto onaj iza leđa tamo vamo, nego da bude nešto konkretno, da se desi, da jednostavno budemo braća bez obzira što nismo iz te vjere.
What do you think when we see you, you started practicing Islam at such a young age, 17 years old, and now you're married, alhamdulillah, you are dedicated to living this beautiful way of life, but now you have a lot of kids 17, 18, right? Even adults in their 20s, and they say, oh man, that's for the old man, right? Maybe I'll go to Hajj, you know, maybe I'll start praying when I'm in my 60s, 70s. But you, world champion, dedicated to living purpose, what advice do you have for people who have that mentality?
Ono što mi je jako smiješno jeste kada stari ljudi kažu da će ipak kada ostare otići na hađ. Kao prvo, evo bio sam, hvala Allahu, na umri već 3 puta. Umra i hađ su 2 različita svijeta po pitanju onaj snage, koliko to treba, koliko ne treba. Tako da mi je najsmiješnije to kada ljudi kažu kada ostarim da će ići na hađ. Ništa, nek oni požure sa hađom, nek idu što prije, nek se pokaju, neka traze istigfar od Allaha Đelešanuhu, da im promijeni stanje, da jednostavno ne vrijedi čekati nikada, ne znaš kad će zakusati melek smrti na tvoja vrata. Danas je nekom otišao na druga, dok je tebe zaobišao, sutra će doći na tvoja, tako da čovjek ne treba čekati da ostari, nego što mlađe to bolje.
Beautiful advice here from the beautiful city of Zenica. And now if you're Serbian, Croatian, Italian, Polish, American, doesn't matter who you are, where you are, but you want to know the purpose of life, you've gotten through all of the hype, you've tuned into the Dean Show, we're just bringing you another story of somebody who made that transition and he's still alive. He was almost killed by that grenade. And now he's dedicated his life. He left off, he became a world champion, and at the young age started committing himself to living the purpose of life. He's happy living a morally upright life. And you could be there too. You could be there too. Worshiping the Creator, not the creation. Make sure you tune in here every week to the Dean Show to learn more. And I hope you benefited from this story and these positive messages that we give out there to you. We'll see you next time. Until then, we wish him peace. How's that? Assalamu alaikum. Peace be with you.
Wa alaikum assalam. Peace, brother.
Peace.